श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम। 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 मंगल भवन अमंगल हारी। द्रव उस दशरथ अजर बिहारी। बिनु सत्संग विवेक न होई। राम कृपा बिनु सुलभ न सोई। श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम। सियावर रामचंद्र की जय। बालक वृद्ध बिहाय गृह लगे लोग सब साथ। तमसा तीर निवास सुखिय प्रथम दिवस रघुनाथ। दिस इज व्हाट वी आर सपोज टू सी लास्ट नाइट। वी स्टॉप्ड इन चौपाई बिफोर दैट। भगवान श्री राम लेफ्ट and all the people of Ayodhya followed him. And in this Doha, this is number 84, it says, they left Balaka Vridha Bihai. They left all the children and the old people at home. Balaka Vridha, older people and children, senior citizens and junior citizens. They left them at home. And then Griha, Lage Loga Sabasat, with all the rest of them, they followed Bhagwan Ram, all the people of Ayodhya. Then, Tamasa Tir Nivasukya Prathama Divas Raghunath. And then on that first day, now they stopped in the Tamasa Tir, River Tamasa. Tamasa River, Tamasa Nadi. That first night, they stopped on the banks of that river. And the ancient tradition among all nomad communities, they usually stop by some water sources there and all. So then, now we have to see that Lord left Ayodhya in gloom and he's making his way into the forest and all the people are following. Let us see what happens then. रघुपति प्रजा प्रेम बस देखी, सदय हृदय दुख भय विशेषी, करुणामय रघुनाथ गोसाई, बेगी पाए अहि पीर पराए, कैस प्रेम मृदु बचन सुहाए, बहु विधि राम लोग समुझाए, ये धर्म उपदेश घनेरे, लोग प्रेम वस फिर ही न फेरे, सील सने उछाड़ी नहीं जाए, असमंजस वस भेर घुराए, लोग सोग श्रम बस गए सोई, कचुक देव माया मति मोई, जब ही जाम जुग जामिनी बीती, राम सच वसन कहे उस प्रीति, खोज मारी रथु हाँ कहूँ ताता, आन उपाय बनी ही नहीं बाता, राम लखन सिय जान चढ़ी, शंभु चरण सिरुनाई, सचिव चलायउ तुरत रथु, इत उत खोज दुराई, सियावर रामचंद्र की जय, सुत हनुमान की जय, महादेव की जय, जय रघुपति प्रजा प्रेम बस देखी, सदय हृदय दुख भय उबिशेषी। भगवान श्री राम देखी, रघुपति देखी, दधि अन्वया। भगवान राम सो इजी, अन्वया इज वेरी इजी। रघुपति देखी, what he saw, praja means all these people from Ayodhya who had come. And how were they? Prema basa means they're all taken over by love. Under the influence of strong love, attachment for Ram. Then, sadaya hridaya. Sadaya is visheshana of hridaya. Visheshana means adjective. Sadaya hridaya means daya means compassion, mercy, kripa, like that, kindness, daya. And then sa means saha, sahit. This you know is all Sanskrit formation. Sahit, wit. His heart is wit, daya, compassion. So sadaya hridaya, his most compassionate and tender, soft heart, like that, you'll have to say then. Dukhu vaya ubi seshi, because of his the softness and tenderness of his heart, he got great sorrow from seeing the people of Ayodhya now in that condition. They're following him. Karunamaya Raghunath Gosai, that Lord Raghunath, who is Karunamaya, the very embodiment of Karuna. Begi Payahi Peer Parai, quickly, Tulsidasi's comment, quickly he feels the pain and sorrows of other people. Because his nature is Karunamaya. His nature is Karunamaya. Maya Pratyaya is there. Means saturated with Karuna. Karuna Maya Raghunath Gosai Begi Payahi Peer Parai, other people's pain he feels very fast because he's the very embodiment of Karuna. Kaisa Prema Mridu Bachana Suhaye, with great love now he spoke to all the people of Ayodhya. Very nice, sweet words. Bahubidhi Rama Loga Samuchai. In many ways he tried to make them understand. Go back to Ayodhya. Ke dharma upadesat khanere. And he tried various ways to give them upadesh along the lines of dharma, duty and this and that. You have a duty there, you have children and old people, you left them. You have duty na. But Bhagavan Ram, Tulsidas, he says, Loga prema basa phirai na phere. None of them went back. He couldn't convince them to go back. Why? Prema basa, again, prema basa, taken over by love. Silu sanehu chadi nahi jai. But Rama, he could not drop his nature, his swabhav, you know, silu saneha. He couldn't drop it. Nature, just now we saw Karunamaya. Nature is like that. Like the sun cannot drop its own nature. So Rama could not drop seal and saneha. Sneha. Saneha is his saneha. Is sneha. It was affection, love. And his great, amiable, kind nature. And so that plunged him into dilemma. Asamanjasa basa. Bhera gurai. He got plunged into dilemma, you know. Means to say what? The people are doing so. Actually, he gave them upadesh on dharma. See, just now it is told there. Kiye dharma upadesh. According to dharma, they are supposed to go back because you left little children and aged people at home. So by dharma, according to the rules of dharma, you are supposed to be. But he doesn't have the heart to say, look. Yeah, huh? That's what he means. He cannot scold. Too soft, Rama. Then what? He found himself in a dilemma. Asamanjasa basa bhera gurai. Then, loga. Soga shrama basa gaye soi. Now all the people taken over by soga shrama. Soga means shoka. Shoka. How came soga? That you've done that sandhi in your class. No, that ga ka changes to ga. You've seen that, na? Like drik. Drik become drig. Drig drishya vivek. Drig drishya vivek, like that. That drik becomes drig. That ka changes to ga when it meets some different letters and all that kind of thing. Or in certain circumstances. Like that. Ka changes to ga. So here, shok, sok becomes sog. Seeing sog? Soga shrama, sorrow and tiredness, weariness. Basa gaye soi, all the people now taken over by this. They went to sleep now. Now, if you're tired, they're not used to walking 40 miles a day, you know. So then when they reached, then out they tired like anything, then they went to sleep now. That first night. Then Bhagwan Ram also. Kachukha deva maya mati moi. And also he added a little deva maya, you know, his own power. So in other words, he made them sleep even more strong. Deva maya, kachukha deva maya mati moi. Added a little deva maya to them. Now that means they sleep like log. Sound sleep. Yeah, log like log, that's true. Jabahi Ram, Jabahi Jam, Juga Jamini Biti. Jam means Yam. Yata Yamam, I told you about that already. The night is, or the 12-hour period is divided into 4 3-hour segments. And 1 3-hour segment is called a Yam. That Yam becomes Jam, see? All year become Jaja. Yam. What in Shivaratri night they call them Prahar. Prahar. Yam. Jabahi Jam Juga. Juga mean two. When two Prahar, two Yam went away, two Jam. Jam means Biti. Biti means expired, went. Jamini is night. Then Rama Sacheva Sana Kaheusa Preeti, and Rama spoke with love now to that Sumantra. Sumantru. Sumantru, nice. He spoke to that Sumantru. Then what he said? Khoja Mari Ratu Hakahutata. Khoja Mari. Mari means Khoja Mari means you and I see Hakahu. Ratu means you drive away the chariot in such a way that Khoja Mari, that the tracks become indiscernible. The tracks get hidden. That the tracks or the trace left by the wheel will not be figured out by these people, he told. Now all the people sleeping, and Deva Maya he induced also. He gave them, you know, anesthetic. That Deva anesthetic, you know. Deva Maya, well, they're sleeping now so strong. Then he told his Sumantru, you drive this chariot in such a way that they can't trace the tracks, you know. An upaya banihi nahi bata. There is no other way in which we can do this. There is no other way in which we can really escape. Then Ram Lakhan Siya Jana Chadhi Sambhu Charana Siru Nai Sacheva Chalayau Turata Ratha Itta Utta Khoja Durai. Ram Lakhan Sita Jan Charai, they went up on the chariot. Jan Charai. Then Sambhu Charana Siru Nai, bowing their heads to Shambhu before going up, bowing their head to Shambhu, Bhagwan Shiva. Then Sacheva Chalayau Turata. And immediately, Sumantru, Sacheva means Sumantru, he's the minister. Sacheva means minister. The minister is immediately, Turata, Chalaya Uratu. He drove off that chariot now. Then, how? Itta Utta Khoja Durai, here and there. He drove that here and there. Itta Utta Khoja Durai, hiding the tracks, means confusing the tracks, so that they can't know where it went. And then you see that, see, Ram Lakhanasya Jana Charahai, Ram went up first now. And just because he was a gentleman, you know, he always put Sitaji first. Now, Ram Lakhanasya, see you last. Because, very clear, easy thing, because it is pitch dark midnight, do jam. Huh? So she will not even know where to put her foot to go up on that, to climb that chariot. So he goes up, so he can, like that. So it's not that by chance like that, you know, so Tulsi Daji just feels, you put, okay, put this one first. Okay, now we put that one first, because that one boring, you know. Yeah. like that. Big midnight it is, and there Tamas, no electricity and all, you know. Tamasa Nadi. So, like that. There's always some reason will be there. Don't think that it's just like that. Arbitrarily, he chooses to. But your duty is to think of the reason. You know why? Just now we saw there he was putting Sitaji first. That was broad daylight. Okay, now, see. Jage sakal log bhay bhoru. Ye Raghunath bhayau ati soru. Rath kar khoj katahu nahi paavahi. Ram Ram kahi chahu disi dhaavahi. Manahu bari nidhi. Manahu bari nidhi budas jahaju. Bhayau bikalavar bane kab samaju. Ekahi ek dehi upadesu. Taje Ram ham jani kalesu. Nindahi aapu sarahahi meena. Jig jeevanu raghubir bihina. Jau pai priya bi yogu vidhi kina. Tau kas maranu namage dinha. Ehi vidhi karat pralap kalapa. Aaye avad bhare paritapa. Bisham biyoguna jai bakhana. Avadi asa sabarakhi prana. Ram daras hit nem brata. Lage karan nar nari. Manahu kok koki kamala. Deen bihin tamari. Siyavar Ramachandra ki jai. Bolo bhai sab santan ki jai. Jage sakal log bhai bhoru. Bhoru means morning. Morning, morning, morning. Bhor bhai. Bhor. Bhor means morning. So when it morning came, jage sakal log, all the people woke up. Then ge Raghunath bhayau ati soru. They started screaming now. Rama's gone! Oh God, Rama gone. Oh God, means, oh Rama. Oh, Rama is himself God. Oh Rama, Rama has gone. Ge Raghunath bhayau ati soru. Soru means, soru means, shor machor, like that. Halahal. Not a, what do you call? Kolahal. Noise like anything. Kolal. Oh, shor machor, big noise. Ratha kar koj. Then they look for the tracks of the ratha. They look for the tracks. Ratakarako jakatahu nahi pavahi. But they could not see, they could not discern that it went here, went there. Where did it go? Rama Rama kahi. Chahu disidhavai, running in all four directions, calling out for Ram, Ram, Ram. Which side? Which side is this Ram? Nothing, they couldn't find. Manahu. Bari nidhi. Bood jahaju bhayav vikala bada banika samaju. How they felt like, you know. Banika samaj means a whole group of merchants coming with their ships on the ocean. And then, bood jahaju, all the ships sink. Bood. Bood means doob. Doob guy. You just flip the word. Doob. Bood, doob. Like that. Where? Bari nidhi, in the ocean. Just like when all their ships sink in the ocean, and all their merchandise gone. Who? Businessmen. Banika. Banika. Eka, eka hi dehi. Upadesu. They all tried to speak to each other, give upadesh to each other, advice to each other, this, that, talking with each other. Taje Ramaham, and then they said, concluded what? Taje Ram. Ram dropped us. Why? Hamajanika lesu. Because he knew this journey is too much for us. He knew that this journey will bring great affliction to all of us. So, ham janika lesu, he knew. Taje Ramaham. He dropped us, left us. Because he knew this is too much. We are not used to this. Means they didn't blame Ram. They knew that Ram did it for a good reason. Then what? Who they blame? Nindahi apu. They blame themselves. Nindahi apu. And then sara hahi mina. And they praise the fish. Suddenly they blame themselves and praise the fish. And then nothing else they're told. They blame themselves and praise the fish. It means to say that the fish is better than they are, because if the fish is taken out of water, they die. And now we are taken out from the presence of Ram, and we still live. How stone-hearted we are. Like that. So they blame themselves, curse themselves, blame themselves, and praise the fish. That is, yeah. Dhiga jeevan. This dhiga you will see again. It'll come. Dhiga means curse. Fire. Fire in our lives. Curse to be our lives. Fire upon us. Raghubir bihina. That we live without the presence of Ram. Jaupe priya biyoga biyogu bidhi kinha. That if bidhi means God, Brahmaji, destiny, like that, fate, all that. Bidhi jaupe priya biyogu bidhi kinha. If this Brahmaji had meant to tear us up away from our beloved Lord. Why didn't he just grant our boon of death? We wanted death now. Instead of tearing us away from our Lord, he should have just granted our boon. What? We wanted to die. So he should have granted that instead. No, he tore us away from our Prabhu. Like that. Ehi vidhikarata pralapa kalapa. In this way they wept with aye avadabhare paritapa, with deep and burning remorse and pain and regret and all, weeping profusely. All of them returned to Ayodhya, all the people. Phir bishama biyoga na jai bakhana. The pangs of separation were indescribable. Bishama biyoga, the terrible pangs of separation, jai navakhana, could not be described. Then, avadhi asa sab rakhahi prana. There were only one asha. Asa means asha. One hope. avadhi. Avadhi means the termination of the end of that 14 years. So they hoped. Their hope lied in that only one thing. What, when that 14 years is? Oh. Avadhi means sima. Sima means limit, end, boundary, like that. So savarakahi prana, and so they kept their lives. They kept their lives with this one hope that this 14 years will get over and Rama will come back, like that. Rama darasa hita neva brata, and then to wish the safe return of Rama, and so to for them to get darshan. So Rama darasa hita, wishing the safe return of Rama so that they'll get darshan. What did neva brata lage charan karana nar nari? All men and women started now engaging in neva brata. All austerities and fasting and all such vows and all such things they took. Wonderful thing, you know. All this sanskara and all, just amazing. This vow in Hinduism, taking vows is a big thing. That is such an integral part of our whole tradition. When you talk about Bhishma Pratignya and all, see what some say, the whole history of a nation is shaped by a vow. Like that. Taking vows is a really big thing. In Bhagavad Gita, we'll see also, Bhagavan talks about taking vows. And in spiritual part, taking vows is a very, very wonderful means of self-transformation. And human beings have this one defect, they always want the other person to transform. They don't want to transform themselves. So to rid ourselves of that defect is done by taking vows. We have to keep taking so many vows all the time, over and over. Yeah. And simple things. Mauna Vrata. You keep quiet. That is the best vow. Yogasya Pratama Dwaram. Yogasya Pratama Dwaram Dvang Nirodha. Where we saw? Vivek Churamani. You go back and see. In simple training language, keep your mouth shut. All language. You know, people talk too much. And all usually nonsense only. Is it funny? No. Is it beneficial? No. You put a little test, na? At least if it's not beneficial, it might be funny at least. Make somebody laugh, you know. You might ease some stress in the person there, you might get some punya karma. Eh? So, at least if it's not beneficial, it should be funny at least. Make a little joke, you know. So any type of vrata. So now all even naranari, all men and women of Ayodhya, they took some vrata, some nema, discipline, some tapas, something. Nema means niyama. Nema means some rule they put to their life. Now, from now I will do like this. Ek sawat, Om Namah Shivaya jap, rose, subha. Every morning. 108 Om Namah Shivaya, Gayatri Mantra, Ityadi, Trayambakam Yajamahe, Sugandhim, Pushti Vardhanam, something. And one who doesn't take vrat, the metal of his personality will never be built. He'll be a weakling yours. This life, next life, and every life. If vrat builds the metal of that personality. So, very, very powerful thing actually. All of them now. And any occasion is enough. See, occasion Ram went away. Any occasion is sufficient to take some vrata. Lage karana nar nari manahu kok koki kamala deena bihina tamari. Like when the sun goes away and that kok koki, those birds. And that lotus that wants the sun. There's one lotus that wants the moon. And there's another one that wants Santamari is the sun. Tama Ari. Tama Ari. Tama means darkness. Ari means enemy. Like that. Now, see. सीता सचिव सहित दो भाई, सिंहवीरपुर पहुँचे जाई, सिंहवीरपुर पहुँचे जाई, पुर पहुँचे जाई, उतरे राम देव सरी देखी, कीन दंदवत हर्षु विशेषी, लखन सचिव सिय किए प्रणामा, सब ही सहित सुख पायो रामा, गंग सकल मुद मंगल मूला, सब सुख कर निहरनि सब सूला, कई कई कोटिक कथा प्रसंगा, राम विलो कही गंग तरंगा, सचिव ही अनुज ही प्रिय ही सुनाई, विबुद नदी महिमा अधिकाई, मज्जनु कीन पंथ श्रम गयउ, सुचि जलु पियत मुदित मन भयउ, सुमिरत जाहि मिटै श्रम भारू, तेहि श्रम यह लौकिक व्यवहारु, शुद्ध सच्चिदानंदमय, कंद भानुकुल केतु, चरित करत नर अनुहरत, संस्कृति सागर सेतु, बोलो भाई सब संतन की, सीता सचिव सहित दो भाई, सिंहवीरपुर पहुँचे जाई, मीन्स सीता जी सचिव सहित दो भाई एंड मिनिस्टर एंड टू ब्रदर्स, सिंहवीरपुर पहुँचे, दे रीच सिंहवीरपुर वे ऑन द बैंक्स ऑफ गंगा वॉज दिस विलेज वे the tribal people lived. Then utare ram, rama got down from that chariot, devasari dekhi, seeing ganga, devasari is ganga, we saw this word many times, I know you should be familiar with those words, devasari, sari means river, deva river, the river of the gods, means the river that came down from swarga, river that came down from the heavens, actually came down from Vaikunth. Devasari dekhi ki nadandavat harashubhi seshi, with great joy in his heart, Rama did dandavat pranam to Ganga. Phir lakhana sachiva siya kiye pranama, then Lakshmana, then the minister, then Sitaji, they all did pranam. Sabahi sahita sukupayau Rama, they all got so much of joy along with Rama doing this pranam to Ganga. Then the reverence for Ganga is still so enormous in India today. once I reached Ganga, first time, or not first time, but I was going to Rishikesh, and I ended up in some bus or something, a bus, and I reached Rishikesh and Lakshmanjula. Big night, like no dark like anything. I got down and I looked there and I saw that Ganga. Of course, it was night and I am alone. I used to travel in there alone. So then I looked like that, got out from the bus. I figured I was in Rishikesh because the fellow said it's going Rishikesh. So I got out there. So then I saw that river. One Mahatma was passing with a kamandal and all. It was a little bit cold, it was cold also. He had shawl and everything, his coldness come on. So I asked, Babaji, ye kaun si nadi hai? Which river is this? I asked. Then he told in Hindi, you know. Oh ho. Are bhai, ye nadi nahi hai. It's not a river. Ye sakshat Bhagavati Parameshwari upasthit hai. See the reverence. It's not a river. This is the mother of the universe herself present here. What river you are telling? He immediately would have known I came from outside. Yeah? So this is the reverence which still is there today. See now from this. What a tradition, what a culture, what a civilization to bring down all of these things. Nowhere to see. If that bhava is there, there will be no pollution of any river on the earth today. But that bhava is also gone in India too. Eh? That bhava has to be. So people pollute Ganga also. And that type of thing has to be protected. But that is, you see, the other way to protect our rivers and protect the natural environment and all that is what? Put laws. Right? But you know what will happen with that. There will be laws, and where there are laws, people will break. When people break the laws, then they will be prosecuted. When they are prosecuted, then this one will get defense lawyer, and that will get prosecuting lawyer. Then somebody will bribe the judge. Then the whole, all only mess, corruption. That is what goes on all the time. And they will find creative ways to pump their affluence and all things into the rivers and all, to break the law, to go around the law, to find loopholes, all sorts of things. But when you get this into the blood of a culture, of a civilization, and this culture into the blood of a civilization, and he sees Ganga, like Bhagavati Devi, mother of the universe, Jagat Janani. What is it? What do you need laws for? That is the social engineering of the rishis. That everybody came into India to destroy. First the Mughals come, destroy. British come, further destroy. You wipe out this culture. The culture to save the earth. Because they have a culture of only ravaging, plundering, looting. That's the culture of the West. That is sanctioned by their religion also. What religion? Yesterday, I had I don't know how many hours I sat in some meeting there. UNESCO meeting. They're getting together to come up with some curriculum to teach religious education in schools. So all the religious people have to come together. And now we have to find out some common things that you can teach into the schools and all of that sort of thing. Amazing thing. There is no need for Hindu to be there because Hindu have no problem with any other religion. Isn't it? You say you want to follow the Bible or you want to follow Quran or you want to follow whatever, yeah? You are most welcome. But in your religion, you have things that want to wipe out the Hindu. We don't have anything to want to wipe out you. So there's no need for us to be there. You go and correct your religion and come back. if you just go and correct those few little things, there's no need for this meeting also. I actually started by telling them, we have a Hindu school here, 98% of the students are Hindus. And in Hinduism, there's an intrinsic respect and reverence for other people's religion. So we don't have to teach our children anything new. We just teach them Hinduism. Then they will respect your religion and your religion and the other person's religion, everything fine. And you want to follow Bible? Take it. Go. You want to follow Quran? Go, you go. Because it's natural. So this type of culture where you rever the Ganga, where you rever the trees and where you rever other human beings, that is the culture. Destroyed by consecutive plunderers, one after the next coming into India to destroy that. But that is the nature of the world. Any good thing will always be destroyed. That which is to save the earth, that will be destroyed. And that's across the board. Anything which is good for human society, they will make sure that they destroy it. That's the rule. So, this Bhagwan Shri Ram did prostrations to this Ganga. Ganga sakala mudam mangalam mula. They got so much joy from this prostration to Ganga. It says Tulsidas is writing now. Ganga sakala mudam mangalam mula. Ganga is the very source, a root of all auspiciousness and joy. Sava sukha karani harani sava sula. It brings all joy, bestows all joy, and removes all impurities and all afflictions. Kai kai kotika katha prasanga Ramu bilokahi Ganga taranga. Looking at the waves of Ganga, Bhagwan Shri Ram told countless stories to Sitaji, to the minister, to Lakshmana. Kai kai koti katha prasanga. All the origin of this Ganga and how Bhagirathi and all, we remember we saw also some parts of that. Sachiva anujahi priyasunai bibudanadi mahima adhikai. And he told all the greatness and glory of this Ganga to the three of them. Sachivahi anujahi priyahi. Priyahi means Sitaji, his beloved. Then majjanu keenha. Then they all dipped in this Ganga. Told the glories of Ganga. Then took a dip in Ganga. You see, the idea is Bhagavad Gita kinchidadhita Ganga jalalava kanika pita. Study a little bit of Gita, one drop of Ganga jal. But if you drink the Ganga jal and we don't have the background, so that's why you see close the glory of Ganga and then take a dip in there. If we don't have the background knowledge and have the reverence and have the greatness of Ganga in our mind, and then we drink, nothing will happen. First we have to have all of that. So first he does prostration, then he does glorification of Ganga, tell all the stories of Ganga. Now when you drink, then you drink with that bhav, isn't it? So here when you dip in Ganga, you dip with that bhav. The presentation by Tulsidas is also very nice. Suchi jalu piyata. After taking a bath, they also drank that pure water. Suchi jala piyata. Oh, majjanu keenha pantha shrama gayau. All the tiredness of that journey went away. Pantha shrama. All the shrama, tiredness of the journey. Gayau. Suchi jalu piyata. And then drinking that jala, pure water of the Ganga. Mudita mana bhaye. Mudita mana bhaya, great joy came to their heart. Sumirata jahi mitai shrama bharu tehi shrama yaha laukika vyavaharu. Look at that. Tulsidas tells, look, Rama drank the Ganga jal and then took a bath in Ganga and all his tiredness went away. That Rama who people remember to send away their tiredness. People remember that Rama to send away all of their tiredness. He is drinking Ganga jal to send away his tiredness, weariness. Tehi shrama. So he said the only way to explain that is यहाँ लौकिक व्यवहारु, दिस इज रामा प्लेइंग अ वर्ल्डली ड्रामा. द ओनली वे टू एक्सप्लेन दैट इज रामा प्लेइंग अ वर्ल्डली एक्टिंग आउट अ वर्ल्डली स्टोरी लाइक दैट. लौकिक व्यवहार शुद्ध सच्चिदानंदमय कंद भानुकुल केतु. द राम इज शुद्ध सच्चिदानंदमय कंद भानुकुल केतु. दट बान ऑफ द भानुकुल द सोलर डायनेस्टी इज कंद. कंद वर्ड मीन्स जो सुख देते हैं. He who gives joy. Kanda. Kam. Kam means sukha. Kam means sukha. And da means dadati. So that Rama who gives joy, that banner of the solar dynasty, Charita Karata Nara. Anuharata Samsriti Sagara Setu. He lives and acts like an ordinary human being. And that life becomes an exemplary life which forms a setu, a bridge for people to cross over Samsara Sagar, Samsriti Sagar. So Rama lives an ideal life of a human being. And when people study the glories of that life lived by Rama, that forms a bridge to cross over samsara. Charita karata nara anuharata. Anuhari means he lives like an ordinary human being. And that charita, studying how Rama lives, that becomes the bridge. So we have to study. In other words, he becomes the exemplar by the way he lives. Okay, we'll see that now. They reach Ganga. Now what? Guha. Guha, that tribal king. Guha, Guha story will start. ओम पूर्णमद पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ओम शांति शांति शांति. हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरि ओम. सो दिस रामायण क्लास.